So let's explore the terminals on the back of this Schneider switch a little bit closer. So here we have a two-way switch. We've got common, one-way and two-way. And now another terminal called loop. I'm not sure that's the right name for it. But this is the terminal where we'll be making our connections for our neutral. Let's explore the fact and see if this loop terminal is physically connected to any other terminals. We wouldn't expect it to be, would we? If we're putting a neutral in here, permanent line and our switching lines in these, we wouldn't expect them to be electrically connected together. So if I bring in my continuity tester, and we test first of all between common, let's go L2, okay, that has a continuity. If we operate the switch, we expect that not to have anything. So, okay, so that's now not got a continuity. So let's go to the L1. Again, that's got a continuity. If I operate the switch, we expect it not to. So that's working correctly in those terminals as we would expect on the back of a two-way switch. But let's go now between common and loop. And now loop and one-way, loop and two-way. Operate the switch again and repeat the process. None of these are connected together. That makes perfect sense, doesn't it? So this terminal down here labeled loop is not physically connected to any of the elements of the switching mechanism. So effectively it's standing alone. So it's no different than the Wago 2-to-1 connector we've currently got in the back of our switch. So this could facilitate for us the neutrals.